Hi everyone, welcome to the show. Happy NFP Friday. We will talk about expectations, possible market reaction in equities and in gold, and also have a word on Tesla sell-off and AMC frenzy. So major US indices came under pressure on Thursday following a series of data pointing at solid recovery on the economic front. So the ADP report revealed that the US economy added almost a million jobs in May, with improved job additions in leisure and hospitality. The initial jobless claims fell below the 400,000 mark for the first time since the beginning of the pandemic last week, in the continuation of a clear waning trend as well. So that's positive news, while the ISM services PMI pointed at a faster than expected recovery in the activity. So strong economic data revived the Federal Reserve hawks and expectations that the bond tapering talk should happen sooner rather than later, especially now that the Fed announced on Wednesday that it would start gradually unwinding its $13.7 billion worth of US corporate debt and ETF holdings. Now, gold tanked below the $1,854 per ounce mark on prospects of a steeper rise in the US yields in case of a sooner than expected monetary policy tightening in the US. On one hand, gold is sensitive to the low risk return. The higher the yields, the lower the appetite of holding a non-interest bearing asset like gold. On the other hand, gold is still a solid inflation hedge, and strong economic data is a boost for inflation expectations and could therefore throw a floor under the gold's feet and the 50-day moving average, which is a touch above the $1,800 per ounce mark, could be that floor. In summary, yesterday's good news was bad news for gold and stock investors, although news that Joe Biden would compromise on corporate tax hike somewhat cooled off the selling pressure across equities. But yesterday's market action or market reaction gave a hint that if we see a strong NFP figure today, then there could be a further sell-off across the equity space, and the technology stocks would be on the chopping block. Now, data-wise or forecast-wise, it's very hard to give a call. A consensus of analyst estimates point that the US economy may have added some 650,000 new non-farm jobs in May, but I wouldn't be surprised to see a figure as low as 100,000 or another as high as a million. Though, looking at the trend in the weekly jobless claims in the US recently, I would rather expect a relatively strong number at or above 500,000 something than a surprise soft figure near the 200,000 as the one printed last month. Now, the technology stocks could come under pressure in case of a strong data, even more so as some big tech stocks, I'm thinking of Amazon and Apple, have already slipped below their 200-day moving average this week, and they are both testing the bottom of a positive trending channel base. So technically speaking, I do not see an alarmingly fast sell-off in these stocks. Right now, the RSI index is not yet in the oversold territory. Therefore, the negative pressure that we see right now could continue in the short run. But as I mentioned in my earlier shows, I don't necessarily see these companies' stocks sent to a significant medium-term bearish trend, even in case of a tighter monetary policy in the US, as besides their gigantic growth potential, these companies keep on impressing their investors big time on their financial results quarter after quarter. This is all to say that the price pullbacks in US tech giants could actually be interesting buy opportunities for long-term players. Yet for those who are willing to risk or accept a certain slowdown in this rally due to an increased appetite for cyclical stocks, obviously, or the value names in the context of a reflation trade building right now. On the index level, we could see a Nasdaq returning to its 100-day moving average near 13,365. That would be just another 1.2% retreat before the weekly closing bell in case of strong NFP data. Yes, as I repeat and repeat again, there is no reliable correlation between ADP and NFP prints. Therefore, the strength we saw in the ADP report yesterday could not reflect in the NFP number today. If that's the case, so if we have a soft NFP figure, I would expect to see some recovery across the board. Now, one stock that may not benefit from good or from bad news is Tesla, which saw its shares shattered by news that its Chinese sales dropped by almost half in May. So the news came after another report showed yesterday that Tesla lost market share in April, and if that wasn't enough, the US regulator disclosed recalls of more than 5,500 Model 3 and Y vehicles and some 2,200 Model Ys on separate seatbelt defects. Well, that's a lot of Tesla recalled and an important misstep, in my opinion, in the actual environment of such a fierce competition that's building among the EV sellers across the world. So the combination of all these bad news for Tesla sent the stock price to a touch above the $570 mark. So the sell-off slowed in the after-hours trading. That's good. So there is also a chance that Tesla found some ground at the current levels for a short recovery. However, if we fall below this level, below the $570 mark, I would drop my short-term bullish call on Tesla, while the medium-term call for further downside correction is still on, and we may even see a steeper downtrending channel on the weakness of the latest short-term recovery wave. So for long-term, however, the picture is different. Investors remain quite divided on where would the stock price head within the next 12 months. Now, there are 33 analysts forecasts on CNN Money Survey, and the medium 12-month price target stands at $730 per share, almost 30% higher than where we are right now. The up end goes all the way up to $1471, while the low end goes all the way down to $67 per share, which actually doesn't look reasonable to me at all at this point. I would rather see the stock price of Tesla within a more reasonable range of $400 to $700 per share for the next 12 months. Now, Tesla was a big loser yesterday, but you know who was a big winner? Ford. Ford was a good winner. Ford is having an exponential rise in its stock price, and it's mostly driven by its electrification efforts. And that's another collateral damage for Tesla, obviously, and unfortunately. So the company, Ford, said it nearly tripled its electric vehicle sales last month. No wonder Tesla is losing its market share. So Ford rallied some 7% yesterday, and seriously, the chart almost looks like a meme stock to me right now, but obviously with solid fundamentals underneath. Of course, Ford hasn't been exchanging hands at these levels since more than 6 years now. I think Ford is a good buy, but not at the current levels. I would still wait for a downside correction to happen to enter the stock, as the RSI index is now deep in the overbought region, warning that the stock has been bought too fast in a too short period of time, and we don't need RSI to be telling that, obviously. I would wait for at least a 10% correction in the price to somewhere below $14 level to jump in. Now, let's finish with news on companies that don't really care about the economic recovery, economic data, the market sentiment, or taxes, but which see their stocks pumped and dumped on social media talk. So I'm talking about AMC, which had a rough session yesterday, down 40%, then up 50% from the dip. So the company even sold 11.5 million more shares, but they warned investors that investing in their stock would lead them to substantial losses, or could lead them to substantial losses. Now, looking at the chart, I see signs of waning and this renewed wave of a short squeeze in AMC. Now, again, fundamentally speaking, the rally in AMC, which is a struggling movie theater chain since pre-pandemic times already, is very, but very hard to justify, given that even the end of the pandemic wouldn't boost the business, in my opinion, to match what we see in terms of price action on the market nowadays. While Hollywood's big producers like Disney, for example, are turning into streaming business, I sadly don't see how a movie theater chain could pull its head above water in the longer run. But the thing is, there is right now just too much liquidity in the market, which leads to this kind of anomalies in the price action. And that's certainly another reason why the Federal Reserve may want to consider a certain readjustment in its monetary policy. Anyway, a final update on pot stocks. We saw some diverging performances across the cannabis stocks in yesterday's session. Aurora and Canopy fell, but Tilray hit and shortly pushed above my $21 per share short-term bullish target. I am now moving sideways in the short run while keeping my bullish view on pot stocks as a whole in the medium to long run. Now, one pot stock which has benefited from the Reddit Wall Street Bets chatter is Sundial, which closed yesterday. Today's session some 14% higher. Sundial is also a top pick in Swissquote for the cannabis theme play, so there is potential for further gains in the medium run, though the actual jump calls for a downside correction in the immediate future. This is all for this week. I'm Ipek Ozkardeskaya, and thank you for joining me. I hope this episode of Market Talk has been helpful and insightful to you. Please do not hesitate to leave your comments, your questions, and your reactions below, and also follow us on Twitter and on LinkedIn for regular market updates, and subscribe to our YouTube channel for daily market comments. I meet you again next week, and until then, good day trading and have a lovely weekend.